Okay, so probably just build some storage here. For sticks and logs and that sort of thing. Maybe a, even though the ocean's really close, I'll probably build a water catchment system here, because it's really cheap to build. There we go. Just until I get my well put in. So I thought about it for quite a while. I wondered if I should go ahead and build a control center so I can get the NPCs here right away. I think I will, but I'm going to do it a little differently because I noticed that there isn't a lot of, not a lot of stone around, like at all, even the little guys or the big ones. I haven't, you know, I've explored quite a bit of the map on a different game and I just can't find any stone fields anywhere. So I might have to do it on wooden foundation. There's tons of trees everywhere. I might just do it right on the ground. It's so flat here, I'd probably be able to get away with doing it on the ground. It'll be kind of ugly because of the trees and brush clipping through, but whatever. I can always take it down and redo it later. So I'll probably put that outside. Let's just finish getting rid of some stuff here. What I'm going to do is just clear this area down here because I think it's the only one of maybe two entrances and exits, and I don't want to keep looking for it every time I get into my car. So I'll know that the area down here that's cleared out is kind of my exit here. Let's get some stamina real quick. Pretty impressed with how flat it is right here. I should be able to build my compound just on the ground, no problem. I don't think I'm going to run into too many collision issues with the ground being unlevel and not being able to place a building down. Maybe we'll get some planks going here. And we'll look at learning the furnace. I need 5 clay. Pretty sure I got that somewhere. I'm pretty sure I got some clay, just a small amount. And if I didn't, then I'm gonna have to run out and grab it. Oh, maybe I don't have any. I thought I grabbed a little bit, but maybe I didn't grab any at all. Yeah, it doesn't look like I have any, so I'm probably going to have to run out and grab some here. See what I'm... okay, I got lots of fuel. But before I go, I'm going to build a little more storage. Actually, I'll move my car. I think I want storage right out here. trying to make some room in my bag so I'm not, so I can grab as much clay as I can get. I know the control center is going to need quite a few bricks. I just don't want to limit myself. Let's have a look here. Whoops, I put that one in backwards, didn't I? I like the idea of it highlighting, but I wish it would maybe not be so bright. I think it highlights a little too strong there. It's a little distracting. Okay, now that we got storage taken care of, I can start getting some stuff organized here. So seeing as I got this AK here, I may as well use it, right? May as well keep it equipped. And 7.62, and this is 7.62, so I should be able to mod that in. And I think I can put the vertical grip on there. I don't know if it matters. Model 2, Model 1, I'm not sure if one's better than the other. Suppressors for pistol. So I'll take these and trade them. And I should be able to mod that on. Oops. So we got a suppressor, magazine, and grip. We just need the sight now. Put that into probably number one, and we'll put my bow in the in here as a backup, and we'll just pick a bag for our go bag. Doesn't really matter. Probably one that doesn't look like any other one that's got a little bit of room in it. Yeah, this one here. We'll make it go bag in our trade bag. A couple more items to trade there. Cotton trousers, that'll come in handy. Not sure if I have any 7.62 ammo, actually. Yeah, I got 4 rounds, so not a lot. So normally I trade off my pistol that comes with the starter kit, but I think I'm going to hang on to it this time. So we need 44 mag, because we're going to have quite a few rounds available for that, I think. 25 per stack. Wasn't it 30 before? Maybe I'm wrong. Oh, that's 5.56. I've got the wrong ammo there. I want this one here. And that one can go into storage. Weapon. Yeah, it is 30. Okay. I don't have that many, hey? One kit with us. I think we're pretty full on fuel, so I don't have to worry about that. A couple of batteries we'll keep with us. Guess I may as well mod it. I'm not sure if suppressors are working properly or not. We will take those batteries for trade. And I'm just about ready to go here. Make sure we have enough water. My energy is pretty low. Yeah, I should have grabbed some clay when I was up there. I totally missed the boat on that one. Trader should have respawned by now. We should be able to get another repair kit, provided that it spawned. I did in another save. I did check after the fifth day, and he didn't spawn a repair kit, which is unfortunate. I'd like to find some more ammo. There's a lot of bandit camps that I discovered. I'm going to need some more ammo for sure. I don't think I can handle them with the bow and arrow because it's just too slow. I'll just get annihilated. Okay, we need energy and some food. We'll eat first and then see where we're at for energy. Only got 2 cans of food. I'm going to have to run down to the ship at some point here. I'm out of sticks. Yeah, that brought our energy up pretty good there. A lot more than I expected, so maybe we'll just do a run for the clay and then head back here and get some stuff going. Not sure if I set my respawn point or not. Hard to target the bed. Oh, we got a stamina boost too. Okay, now I'm gonna need a stone, 3 stone and a stick for a pickaxe. And we'll head out. We'll be able to find a stick up there. Oh, there's one. All right, here we go. Let's go get some clay. I remember a big clay field by the area that I spawned. So I shouldn't have a problem getting tons of clay up there. I am going to fill up my bag, so it's going to be a bit of a boring step here. But And that's about the only field that I've seen. The clay field was where I spawned. Whoa, hello. So I don't want to, I want to take advantage of being there, so I may as well pick up as much as I can. In my other game, you know, I did put together a test game because there is a lot, I was running into a few bugs there, and I wanted to test out a few different things, and turns out that I did find quite a few more clay fields. But they're all over the place. I actually went to all the merchants because I wanted to see who else sold the car repair kit. And so this guy does here, Mike, right? If you look at it here, it's Mike. And I found I couldn't find another car repair kit merchant out of all of these guys. until I got to this one here, and it was also Mike, and he had the exact same inventory. So I think all the Mikes that spawned are the ones who are going to carry the car repair kits. And I think that's the same for every other merchant here. So if you run into two merchants or three merchants with the same name, they're going to have the same inventory, I think. And he did have another kit, so that's perfect. And we need 15 for that. I may as well grab those advanced parts too. So what do I need here? I need 41. Shouldn't be a problem. I have these batteries here. They should be worth about 25 apiece. Unless something's changed. I've got these two guns here too I want to get rid of. We'll just go have a look. So that gave me 25, and that's 50. It's still a bit much. I think these are 25 also. I want to... Actually, I'll give them a deal, because I should find more tradables. It shouldn't be a problem. Unless I want to take a couple rounds with me too, or maybe the chili. He doesn't really have anything else that I want. Maybe the 9mm ammo. Or a 92. Oh, I can't split. So, yeah, that's about it then. I think I need that alcohol for a recipe. Yeah, whatever. He gets a deal. So now we have another repair kit. That's excellent. Actually, I can probably put that in here now. Because we're right at 50. There we go. Yeah, I think these cars need a little more horsepower. It's kind of ridiculous that I can't drive up these roads fast. I struggle to get up them. I'm wasting a lot of fuel trying to get up the road. I'm not actually sure how fuel is calculated, whether it's calculated on distance or the time the engine's running. So if it's on distance, then that's fine. But if it's on time running, then I'm wasting fuel trying to get up these hills. And look at that, there's a abandoned camp right there. That'll be the first one we hit, I think. Yeah, they don't like me already. But I don't want to do that until we get a command center built, because the NPC doesn't spawn until that point. I'm going to go a little off-road here. I notice there's a lot more railings in game, which really sucks. I thought it was kind of cool. It was a neat addition, but now it's, you know, to find an opening to get anywhere in game now is a bit of a pain in the ass. Was it this? Did I spawn here? I can't remember. Maybe not. Maybe it was the one south. Whoops. Dang it. Because I know there was quite a big clay field right where I spawned there at the beginning of the game. My memory is just garbage now. Yeah, it wasn't here for sure. So it'll be... Oh, great. I'm stuck and there's a bear. Oh, no. I just died, basically. I can't get out of this. There's nothing I can do. Hello, bear. Are you hurting my car? I can't tell. This sucks. How am I supposed to get out of this situation? I'm stuck. Oh, I'm moving a little. Come on. Maybe he's pushing me. Maybe he's helping me actually get out of here. Oh, look at that. Yeah, so let's... Oh my god, what the hell? Let's not go here again, ever. I thought this is where I spawned. I think it is where I spawned, but I think I ran to the other trader and discovered the clay field there. Gotta be careful, because I don't want to destroy my car right away here. That frickin' bear. Oh, I'm getting hurt. Look at my health on my car. Just trying to keep momentum here, because climbing hills is a real pain now. I think the developer is trying to get us to not go cross country four-bying with our vehicles anymore. with all the barriers that are up and all the hills now. Like, look at this. It's so slow. I went to the wrong merchant. This is completely my fault. I screwed this one up. Oh, this is terrible. Look at this. 6, 7, 8 miles per hour. Yeah, we won't be doing this again. I think we'll be taking the road. It's just, this new map has turned into a bit of a pain. I think we're spoiled with the old map. I can see some clay though, so that's a good thing. That bear encounter could have totally went completely different, because I just about hit the E key to get out of my vehicle so I could deal with the bear or run away or something. I'm glad we managed to get out of there. Here we go. Let's start picking up some of this clay here. Just for reference, I should be just north of this merchant here. I think this clay field actually goes all the way to the merchant. There's actually clay around the merchant, so there's quite a bit here. It's quite a large field. So there's going to be some limestone here too, and I don't think I'm going to grab any of it because I can now break down, what are they called, the shoulder lamps, and I get 3 glass per, and that's a lot of glass. I don't really need to grab the limestone. I'm sure I can use it for something else, maybe concrete, but I'll save the space for now. I'll come back if I need it, like way down the road. It's strange too, like there's barely any stone on the ground anymore, like loose stone like these, and sticks also. So I'm not sure if that's got something to do with the developer trying to avoid rendering issues because the map is so big now, or what, but it definitely makes for a, you've just got to rethink your strategy on building. I mean, it might improve in the future here. They might actually increase the spawn of the stone and the small stuff on the ground, but until then, it's going to be a pain. I don't want to go too far. I don't want to lose my car. I already lost my car. It's got to be here somewhere. Grab some silver here, too. I'm going to need it. I see my car there. No sticks. It's just so strange. The last map, they were everywhere. Oh, I got 2 sticks on me. I'm gonna lay down for a minute and get my fatigue up. So I've got a little more stamina to play with. We'll grab a little limestone. I think I need a little bit to learn a couple of recipes there. I may as well have a little bit on hand. And the limestone has rocks in it too, or stones or whatever they're called. I guess I should grab some stone also while I'm here. I'm going to need them to make the bricks. I think I need clay and stone together to make the bricks. I don't want to fill up too much on the stone though. I'll keep collecting the silver because I think I need silver for advanced parts when I get the machining table built. I still haven't seen a blueprint, so I don't even know if that's a thing yet. So here's my plan. Here's my... Oh, did I leave my freaking bags back there? Oh, no. I did, didn't I? Oh, my goodness. Ah, oh, there they are. Yeah, that could have been really bad. Where's my car? Right there. Bags are right here. Of course, I picked the two camouflage bags to put down and lose. Am I going to be able to find this again? I'm just going to have to, you know what I'm going to have to do is... Oh, yeah, I should be able to find it again. Good thing I didn't start heading home. I would have had to go back to the video to see where I left them. May as well get this learned. I think I can learn it. There we go. So yeah, I should probably get heading back. We're on day 7 now, and I want to get some things built and going. I still have Horde Night too, right? So I've got to get my defenses built up. I might actually do Horde right where I'm at instead of going to the ship. Might just be easier. The first run, the first Horde Night shouldn't be that difficult. At least I hope it isn't. And if I die, I'm like right there. I just don't really have any weapons yet, so I'm not sure if it's a smart move. I've only got my bow and arrows. I'll just grab a couple more. I think I'll just fill up to my weight limit here, and we'll head back. I should have enough clay to do the to learn all the recipes I need to get to brick and the furnace. I think I need 15 bricks for the furnace. I think it's 4 clay per brick, so that's quite a bit. But I have gathered quite a bit already. And I think the troll center is, what, like 25 or so bricks? Just have a look here. Bricks, so that's a lot. Maybe I should just stay and keep gathering for a bit. It's gonna take forever, too. Probably wouldn't be a bad idea to build more than one furnace. Maybe I'll just stick around here for a little bit and pick up enough to build more than one furnace, maybe 3 or 4, and that way I can get the bricks a lot quicker. So basically each one of these stacks is a brick, right? I mean, not exactly, but that's a rough estimate idea way of looking at it. Let's grab a few more. Running low on energy too, so I may as well get going. I don't want to be doing this during the summer either. You know, and it is spring, so I can put on all my clothing and maybe try that bandit camp close to home. I probably won't make it because I don't have any weapons, but at least this way I won't overheat while I'm trying to take care of the bandits. Otherwise, I'm going to have to wait till winter for it. The trick is to get back onto the road without hitting a barrier. I'm going to have to try to figure out a way to get through here. And I think that's it. I think we'll head home. Try not to forget my bag. Well, I don't see any barriers. I think we got lucky here. Built. I think these ones I can have out in the rain. I don't think I can have the other one out in the rain, so maybe I'll build these ones outside. Yeah, we'll just put them right here. And again, I can always get my material back too when I'm done with them. Stone, log, and clay, lots of clay. Good thing I have the clay. 20 clay a piece, that's a lot. Some stones and logs. Metallurgy level 1. Well, that happened a lot faster than it normally does. I wonder if that was adjusted. Usually I have to bring my mood back up a couple times before I gain a level. But that was quick. That's good. So maybe that time was cut in half. Could be wrong, but that's what it feels like. Now I need to learn brick. Confirmed, and then I need 2 brick for the furnace. Just find a couple more stones so I can do 9 all the way across. Stone are so rare now for some reason. I don't understand it. Like I said, I wonder if it's got something to do with clutter and rendering and optimization, that sort of thing. Those, there are definitely not as many. Tons of trees still. I mean, maybe not. Well, yeah, it's still quite a few trees, so not sure what the deal is. I'm sure it'll come in a future update. I'm just not sure if the game is fully optimized to handle that much clutter on the ground, that much rendering. That's it for stone, huh? Well, better than not having any. I think I'm going to need some for my furnace, too. We got 1 brick, and we got 2 bricks. So now we can go ahead and learn the furnace. Unless I need some skill points for it. I need nothing, so we're good. There it is, and we'll put that one inside because it will not work out in the rain. And I'm going to be accessing it from this side more often than not, so we'll face it this way here. instead of running. Well, yeah, I still have access. I think I have to hit it like at this angle to open it up, so it'll be fine. 15 stone, 9 clay. Well, we have the clay, a little more stone, some, oh, and the brick, right? Yeah, that's what we're waiting on. Let's run out and cut a couple trees. Look at my energy there. Maybe I'll lay down for a minute. I'm not sure if I have any food left. We'll just lay down for an hour or two. We'll make it 3. I hate to waste the time. I really, really need that time. But that'll fill me just about right up. There we go. So the next trip is going to be to the ship for sure, because I'm going to need food. And now I need an axe. Great. Keep looking for a stone around here, but I've already collected them all. I got to stop doing that. I just got to run out and grab them. Wonder if I have enough left on this pick to break up a rock. I probably have everything I need to make a cart too, so I could run around with a cart and just fill it up. Maybe I'll hold off. I didn't use the cart too much last time. It kind of got in the way more than it helped. And 15 brick, and then that should be done. I just turned up the brightness a little bit there. It's starting to get dark out. Look at that. Look at how many brick we've already got. Like, this is so fast. Usually one brick takes forever, right? But I got 4 of these guys going now, so like one brick is 30 seconds. That's a long time when you need them. Excellent. Furnace is done. And we can get to smelting. And it'll provide some light for us too. Oh, I've got to learn the whatchamacallit first, the iron bars first. And for that, I'm going to need metallurgy level 1, which I should have, and a copper nugget and an iron nugget. And this one, I need metallurgy level 2, which I do have the book, so I can get started on that too. We'll start with the iron for sure. All right. Yeah, I turned up the brightness so that furnace is really bright now. A little brighter than I wanted. Look at how bright that is. Probably a little too bright. Yeah, it's a little better. Okay, so we got that going. Now I think what we're gonna do is try to place the control center. See if I can get it on the ground here. Oh, I forgot how big it was. Oh yeah. Okay, so the front will be here, and you know, if I have this and I rescue one NPC, then I will have no problem having Horde Knight at home for the next, you know, 3 or 4 Horde Knights, because they're not that powerful, right? Look at all the flat ground I have around here. We'll put it here. We'll just try that. I think I can make that work. That's not too bad. There's lots of room around it. Look at all the stuff I need, though. Quite a bit. I almost have enough brick already. That's crazy. So I might shut this down. I'll just pick up the brick that's here. And, well, it'll make 3 more. I think I need 2 more. I'll just let it finish out there. 5 toolbox. And wire. And advance. Oh, look at that. I almost have enough. That's amazing. Not sure if I need any of those. We'll go ahead and throw those in. More simple parts. Quite a few more. That one is 45 cement. I'm going to be pretty close on that too, I think. No, I don't have it. Yeah, it looks like we're going to run across the street here for sure. I'm going to need that cement, unless I want to try to make it myself. I think it takes limestone. I do have some. I think the cost was just way too much on the last map to make it, so I decided against it. That must be in my bags. Well, I do have enough advanced parts. I might actually just go ahead and make my pottery bags here that I need. I know it's not worth it though, but I might just go ahead and try. I feel like I'm missing a bag. Oh, I need metallurgy too. Probably a lot quicker just running across the street and picking up the concrete. Oh, so close. Three limestone, one clay, and one iron ore. So, you know what? I might just go ahead and try to make that here. We'll see how many bags I need and see how much material I have. Quite a few, huh? 25, 28. Wow. That I'm going to get across the street. It'll be a lot faster. We'll go to the industrial facility and try to get some concrete and maybe some other supplies while I'm there. Right across the street there. Shouldn't take too long. I just got to figure out how to get out of here.